Electricity is one of the most fundamental and essential aspects of modern life, powering everything from our cities, homes, and workplaces to the devices we use every day. Understanding the basics of electricity is crucial for anyone who wants to work with or around electrical systems, whether as a hobbyist or a professional. One key concept in electrical theory is Ohm's law, which describes the relationship between voltage, current, and resistance in a circuit. By mastering this law, you can begin to understand how to calculate the behavior of electrical systems and make informed decisions about how to work with them. In this video, we will explore the fundamentals of electricity and introduce you to Ohm's law, providing you with a foundation for further exploration and learning in the field of electrical engineering. If you enjoy this video, please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons to our channel for more upcoming videos. The first fundamental concept we will talk about is the voltage, also known as the electric potential difference. It refers to the electric potential energy per unit charge in an electric circuit or system. Voltage is measured in volts and represents the force or pressure that drives electric charges to flow in a circuit. It is responsible for powering electrical devices, such as lights, motors, and electronic appliances. The best way to understand the meaning of a voltage source is to imagine a water pipeline system with an upper and a lower pool and a pipe between both. In the circuit case, instead of water, it contains negative load carriers, represented by small minus signs, and positive load carriers, indicated by small plus signs. In this scenario, an electrical flow is represented by a flow of small minus signs. The force of gravity causes the water to flow down from the upper pool to the lower pool. As you may have guessed, there should be a potential energy difference between the two water pools to have a water flow. The potential energy difference in an electric circuit can be generated by a voltage source like a battery. Please note if we want to move the water from the lower pool to the upper pool, we should utilize an external mechanical device like a pump. In such a case, the mechanical pump would act as the voltage source. This example will be utilized in the next section. Voltage can vary in magnitude and polarity, determining the direction and intensity of current flow in a circuit. So, understanding voltage is crucial in designing and analyzing electrical circuits, as it plays a vital role in determining the behavior and performance of electrical systems. The second fundamental element of an electrical circuit is current, which is abbreviated by a capitalized I, and measured in amperes. The current describes the movement of the electrons in a conductor, such as a wire, and is represented by an arrow, which shows the direction of the electric current flow. It is necessary to clarify one point in this animation. The actual movement of the electrons is from the negative pole to the positive pole, while the technical direction of the current is agreed to be the other way around. Electric current is driven by voltage, which provides the force or pressure to push electrons through a circuit. The flow of electric current is essential for the operation of various electrical devices and systems. Let's revisit the water pipeline analogy for a moment. In this analogy, the voltage source can be compared to a pump that performs electrical work, pushing electrons to the upper pool and giving them the potential to flow up the pipe. Wherever a flow of electrons occurs, there is always some kind of resistance. This resistance is called the electrical resistance of a component. For example, any electrical conductor like a wire has a resistance, which has to be as small as possible in order to minimize any losses. The actual reason for the electrical resistance is a fundamental property of materials that determines how much they hinder the flow of electric current, which we will cover in a separate video. Electrical resistance is typically denoted by the symbol R and is measured in ohms, shown with the Greek letter, omega. Now let's check the areas in our water pipeline analogy where we are posing resistances against the water flow. First, the piping system exhibits a relatively small level of resistance. However, the significant resistance in the water pipeline system will come from the turbine. As you can see in the animation, while the water starts flowing from the upper pool to the lower pool, it needs to flow through the turbine. The water flow will cause the blades on the turbine to start rotating. This means the additional resistance from the turbine acts against the flow of energy, and in return, the turbine rotates. Now in an electrical circuit, this will be in the form of energy release in electrons, causing the electric current flow to slow down. The energy release can be in the form of heat in a resistance. After providing an overview of the three fundamental elements of an electrical circuit, namely voltage, current, and resistance, we will now explain the relationship between those three electrical quantities. In order to better understand how these three parameters work together to operate an actual electrical circuit, here we will combine all three previously explained and water pipeline systems together to build a water cycle. If you have heard the name Ohm's law, this is where it comes into play. Ohm's law describes that the voltage equals the resistance times the current. So you can remember this formula by the word VRI. Let's examine how Ohm's law can be applied to our water cycle analogy. When the voltage, represented by a larger and stronger pump, increases while the resistance, illustrated by the turbine, remains unchanged, more electrons can be transported to the upper pool within a given time. Consequently, more electrons can flow down to the lower pool per unit of time, resulting in a higher current, which aligns with the VRI formula. Conversely, let's assume that the resistance increases, which can be demonstrated by a larger turbine, but the voltage source or pump remains unchanged. Consequently, the flow of electrons to the lower pool encounters more obstacles, leading to a reduction in the current. This observation also corresponds with the VRI formula. Let's draw a comparison between the various components of the water cycle and an electrical circuit. In this analogy, the pump is equivalent to the battery in the circuit, the turbine represents the light bulb, and the flowing water in the pipeline represents the electrical current in the wires. The general operation of both the mechanical system and the electrical system examples appears to be quite alike, as evidenced in both cases. In both water cycle and electrical circuit systems, an energy source like a pump or battery is necessary to rotate the turbine or light bulb through a medium such as the water in the pipeline or electrical current in the wires, respectively. Now, let's review the relationship between the three fundamental elements of electricity using different mathematical expression forms of Ohm's law. As mentioned earlier, in the context of physics and electrical engineering, Ohm's law establishes the relationship between voltage, current, and electrical resistance. Ohm's law may be expressed mathematically in three different forms. First, the voltage is equal to the current times the resistance as shown in the first equation. This means that the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage applied across it. In the second equation expression, the current is equal to the voltage divided by the resistance. This equation arrangement expresses the inversely proportional relationship between the current to the resistance of the conductor. In the last equation form, the resistance is equal to the voltage divided by the current. This means that the resistance, or the ratio of voltage to current, for all or part of an electric circuit at a fixed temperature is generally constant. This had been established by 1827 as a result of the investigations of the German physicist Georg Simon Ohm. This fundamental relationship is widely used in the analysis and design of electrical circuits and provides a fundamental understanding of how current, voltage, and resistance are interrelated in electric systems. Besides voltage, current, and resistance, there are two more elements that are very important to know when it comes to the basics of electricity. They are called the electric field and the magnetic field. We will cover these two fundamentals in detail in Part B of this video. So please make sure to subscribe to our channel to be notified of it. Thank you for watching this video, and please don't forget to leave your comments on what other engineering videos you prefer us to create for you in our next videos. Goodbye.